गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मंजुषा पाल, यू आर विथ मी इन द मैथ्स क्लास अगेन. ओके, सो अप टू लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कवर्ड टॉपिक्स, वी हैव कवर्ड योर टॉपिक्स. वी वर डिस्कसिंग एक्सरसाइज 1.1. वी हैव डन क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, राइट, इन आर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स. And in today's lecture, we are going to discuss abacus. So our today's topic is abacus. Dear students, what is abacus? You have done some questions on based on abacus in your previous classes also. So let's take a review of abacus. Abacus, it is a simple device. It is a simple device you can make. You can use to make calculations. What you use abacus? You use abacus to make calculations like addition. You can add, you can subtract, you can multiply, you can divide, and more calculations. Okay. So basically, abacus is a simple device you can use to make calculation. And what kind of calculations? It can be used to count, add, subtract, multiply, and more. Okay, I'm repeating one more time. What is abacus? Abacus is a simple device you can use to make calculations. Abacus is a simple device you can use to make calculations. And what kind of calculations? It can be used to count, add, subtract, multiply, and division, and many more. Okay, here let's take an example of 3-digit abacus. Is a 3-digit abacus. Okay, the 3-digit abacus. Here 3 digits are there. Ones, hundred, ones, tens, and hundreds. You know that in 3-digit ones place, tens place, and hundreds place comes. So for 3-digit abacus, you draw only ones, tens, and hundreds place.
Means here you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4 is standing.
let's do question number 1 of exercise 1.1. That is on page number 5. Open, everyone, open page number 5. Everyone, please open page number 5. Exercise 1.1. Write down the numbers represented on the abacus. Your question is write down the numbers represented on the abacus. Here abacus are given, you have to count the bits and write down the numbers. Okay, so let's do it. Here you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 spikes are there. In given abacus, 5 spikes are there. So you can call it 5 spike abacus. So 5 spike abacus is given. Ones place, tens place, hundreds place, thousands place and 10,000 place. You can see that at ones place 2 beads are there. At tens place count how many beads? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 beads are there. 3, 4, 5 and 6 beads are there. At hundreds place, 3 beads are there. So I draw 3 beads. Okay. At thousands place, 2 beads are there. So I am drawing 2 beads. At 10,000 place, 4 beads are there. So I am drawing 4 beads. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So for this given abacus, you have to write the number. You can see that in your question, blank places are given. Here, you have to write the number. So, how you will write? You will count the digit. You will count the beads at ones place and write the number. So, at ones place, how many beads are there? 2 beads. So, write 2 at ones place. At tens place, how many beads? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Tens place. Here you can see that at hundreds place 1, 2, and 3. 3 beads are there. So you will write 3 at hundreds place. Now move to the next spike. What are these? These are spikes. Okay. Move to the next spike, that is thousands spike. And here 2 beads are here. So write 2 at thousands place. Now move to the next left spike. How many beads? Come at tens place. Here you can see one bead is there. So you will write one at ones place, one at tens place. Okay, now move to the left. At hundreds place, count the beads. How many beads are there? Count it fast. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you will write 4 at hundreds place. Okay, now move to the left. That is at thousands. 1, 2, and 3. 3 beads are there, so write 3. And at 10,000s, 2 beads are there, so write 2. This is how you do. Okay. And the last one, that is C. It is also a 5 spike abacus, right? Let's do it fast. It is also, here you can see that a question number 1, C, 5 spike abacus is given. So draw it.
Next questions. That is, write down
column in B. Means here now you have to do the question number B again. What is the question? You have to add 4 more beads at thousands column. Now in question number B, you have to redraw the abacus, given abacus. Okay, you have to redraw. One beat, now I will write the new number name. Okay, so that question number 8 as second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth are done. If you have any doubt or you want to practice some more questions based on this, you will pause the video, do some more questions based on this, then play the video again.
See that 71,206, 72,206. in 7, 7 is common. 260 is common only. Thousands place is here. In thousands place 1 is there. What will come at thousands place? 4 will come. In next place, what will come at thousands place? 5 will come. Likewise, we do this. Okay? So write it for the blank here. The remaining digits will be same. Only at thousands place, our value will get changed. So here 7 is there only at thousands place. What will come here after the 3? 4 will come, and the remaining digits will be same. In the same manner, all the digits except thousands place will be same. So here at thousands place I write 5, and here what I will write at thousands place? 6. Good. Okay. Skip counting. If you have doubt in doing this, you can do in rough work also. As skip counting 10 is there, so you will add 10 10 10 10, and you will get the answer. Okay, here it was counting 100, so you will add 100 100 100 100. Here counting 1000, so you will add 1000 1000 1000. Okay, so you will get the answer. Now the next one is counting. So now which place will get changed? 10,000 place will get changed. Okay, I am rubbing these. Any doubt, or if you want to practice more questions based on counting
tens, count in hundreds, count in thousand, count in 10,000, please pause the video here and practice some more question on, based on this topic, then move further. Okay, now let's start question number 9. Here put the missing commas and write in words. Here you have to put the question number 9 is put the missing commas, put the missing commas and write in words. Put the missing commas and write in words. So let's do A. A number is given, 7895. This number is given over here in the question, okay? And for this you have to put the comma and write in words. So what is this shape to these? First of all, you will make a place value chart for it. So here you can see that 1, 2, 3 and 4 digit. A 4 digit number is given there, so you will make a place value chart only for 4 digit numbers. So make it with me. Ones place, tens place, hundreds place and thousands place only come here. You know that
question number B is 3, 4, 9, 5, 2. how many digits in this question? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 digits are here. So you will make a place value table for 5 digits. So make it periods, places, then number. Thousands period for 5 digits and ones period. Ones place, starting from the right, ones place come, then tens, hundreds, thousands and 10,000 places come in 5 digit plus value chart. Okay, now put, now fill the given number in the place value table. Now fill the given number in the place value table. Here 2 is at ones place, so put 2 in ones column. Then 5 at tens place, then 9 at hundreds place, then 4 at thousands place, then 3 at 10,000 place. Okay, we have done our first step, that is put, we have put all the numbers in place value table. Now put the comma according to period. So rewrite the given number. Okay, I have rewrite the given number. Now put the comma. Where you will place the comma or put the comma? Where will you put the comma? You will put the comma when a period gets over. Start from the right side. You can see that once period is over. Once period is over at after the hundreds place. Once period is over here and then thousands period is starting. So when, where once period gets over, you will put a comma. Place a comma here, put a comma here. This is how we put a comma. Now write in word. Write in word. So you will read the number together, then its period. Okay. If I hide these two numbers, can you read this number? What is this? It is a 3-digit number. You can read 3-digit number very easily. Right? How you read 3-digit number? You read this first number. First number, then its place, then these last two number together, that is you will read this 952 as 952, right? But here 5 digit number is there, so how you will read it? You will read these two number together, then its period. So it is 3 and 4, 34. So 34, the number gets over, then its period. Its period is 1000. So write 1000. 34,000. And this 3-digit, last 3-digit number, you will read simply 952. This is alone in its place. This number is alone in its place. And this number together. 34,952. Okay, so I am stopping today's class over here. The remaining question of question number 9, you will do it by yourself for the practice. Okay, thank you. We will meet tomorrow with the new exercise, with the new topic. Bye students.